Hey boys and girls, I'm Rhino. Today I'm teaching you about protein, why we eat the protein and what it does for our body and how proteins are different because not all protein is the same. Yay! And then you can have well-informed and sassy comebacks every time you encounter a socially awkward situation like I do, because I'm a vegetarian and sometimes I end up at a barbecue. I'm like, glad to be here. I'm not going to eat anything. And then the guy behind me is like, well, I'll eat the meat because I understand the importance of protein. Well, I'm sorry. I only understand lysine, leucine, isoleucine, valine, methionine, phenylalanine, tryptophan, threonine, and histidine. Proteins enter the body the same way luggage arrives at the airport. You get to the airport, you have your overhead and your checked bag, they separate, they travel, they arrive at their new destination and are reunited at baggage claim. So when a protein enters the body, it is separated into amino acids so that it is small enough to travel into things like your central nervous system. And then once it arrives at its destination, it is reunited with its amino acid buddies and they make new proteins and do magical, wonderful things. Yay! Now there are 22 different types of amino acids in the body. 9 of them we call essential amino acids because these you actually have to ingest. The others are already created in your body, which is wonderful. The one exception being arginine. This is the 10th essential amino acid that as a kid you will want because it's responsible for growth spurts. But as an adult, we produce enough to be satisfied. Now the other 9, we'll start with a cool one. We've got methionine. So methionine is going to create creatine, which is energy for the muscles. It'll break down fat in the liver and create collagen, which is great for your hair, skin, and nails. It is not the only one beneficial for tissue. We've also got histidine. Histidine, one of the tissues it likes to work on, brain tissue. So up there in the brain, you've got the histidine working, but you also have phenylalanine. Phenylalanine helps with our mood stabilizers like dopamine, epinephrine, norepinephrine. These things help us function well mentally. So if our amino acid balance was off, we'd end up with something like depression. Now, it's not the only hormone that's happening up there. We've also got serotonin. Serotonin is thought to help us sleep well, and serotonin is created by tryptophan. Tryptophan also helps with the central nervous system and making sure it functions properly, along with threonine. Now, threonine does a lot of other cool things. It also helps with our cardiovascular system. It balances out all the proteins, kind of like the mediator of the proteins. And it also helps with the fat in the liver and your immune system. It does not do the immune system by itself, though. We've also got lysine. Now, lysine also is kind of the awkward one because it's antiviral, which means it helps out with things like herpes. Yep, lysine is the herp one. It would make sure that like cold sores could appear less frequently if you had the proper amount of lysine in your body. Now, it's not the only thing lysine does. Obviously helps the immune system, antiviral, yay, but it also helps with bone growth and maintenance. Not the only one that helps the growing, we've also got leucine. Leucine helps with growing. Leucine also helps with breaking down visceral fat, which is that hard to get out fat, and it comes in a trio. It likes to work with valine. Valine helps remove nitrogen from muscles, and isoleucine. Isoleucine helps clot the blood so that if you were to cut yourself, your blood will clot so you stop bleeding. Yay! The three of them together like to give your muscles energy and repair those muscles. Now, if you are exercising a lot or you're an athlete, these proteins and amino acids, these are what you want to have an abundance of because you're going to burn through that energy. It's creating muscle energy, but it's fuel. It's a finite amount. So it takes a while to figure out exactly how much of each you want to ingest. But like anything, caffeine, for example, it'll give you a little perk, but too much will make you jittery. So, you know, you gotta find the balance, people. Gotta find the balance. Now, if you're worried about what to eat, look below in the description. I will show you, or list rather, each amino acid and what food it can be found in. Cursory example, if you were to eat edamame, mushroom, rice, and beans all together, you have now covered all 9 essential amino acids. That's why we say complementary proteins, because you're taking 2 different foods that offer 2 different proteins and putting them together so that they complement each other. Like having the leucine, isoleucine, valine, it's a nice little trio, they complement each other, it goes well together. Yay! Now, If you would like to know about any other sciencey things, please leave a comment below. Ask me any questions about protein. I'll make sure to list my sources as I do. And I also take recipe requests, because of course, this is also a cooking show. Yay! So tune in Monday, we are making barbecue. Check out my videos of gluten, carbs, fat, and iron. Thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe. Have a good one.